Now, Nydia, where were you yesterday?
I was at home.
Reading. We did. We were worried.
Yeah, well, thank you very much for your concern, and I appreciate that.
You can borrow my
car. No. Remember on Star Trek, the gal that used to wear that thing right here? She was a communicator.
Well, sure, yeah. What's her name?
Uhura. Yeah. Something like that.
Uhura. Uhura. That's you.
Yeah.
Mr. Uhura.
Gentlemen,
good morning. How are you doing?
How are you doing today?
Well, thank you. Good morning.
I don't know where if they put you to the court appreciation, that might also be.
I'd like to call the special call meeting Wednesday, May 9th, 8 a.m. of the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners to order, please, at 5 minutes after 8. I have a statement to read here, please.
This does need to go into the minutes, Mr. Chairman.
All commissioners are present. Due to the impending expiration of the raw and finished water agreements, the necessity of delivering response to the City of Cummins' latest water proposal prior to the City's May 15th meeting, and the lack of availability of a forum of the board prior to the 15th, a special circumstance existed warranting that this meeting be called with less than 24 hours notice. Thank you. And I apologize for my voice again today. If we would all stand for a short invocation, please. Dear Heavenly Father, please guide us in making the immense decisions that we're called upon to make for the citizens of the entire county. Please guide us in doing the right thing and show us the way to have some sort of a reasonable agreement. In my name we pray, amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Adoption of the agenda. So far there's just one item on the agenda. Is there any addition, deletion, or modification? If not, is there a motion to adopt the agenda as printed?
So moved.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously.
Mr. Chairman, before we start item one, I'd like to recuse myself in discussion. I'll vote at this moment. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay. Yesterday we were talking about Brian's offer, I believe, for an offer that Brian had put together. Does anybody have any further thoughts or modifications to that, or come up with another proposal they'd like to start to discuss?
I have something to offer.
Okay.
I think it'd be wise if we take the city's agreement and do a counteroffer, respectfully do a counteroffer to it, and I have some ideas on what that counteroffer could be. Based on the intake, and I guess Dave Bruin, if you decided it may be better not to pay the 11.4 part, better to do it over time or not, for like as if it's a lease.
For cash flow purposes, it would be, I think, in the interest of the county utility to keep that $11 million on hand for a capital program.
All right. In addition, so we work out some sort of lease. I guess that's what their offer was to begin with. So no payment for the intake, including. And although we will, I'm considering, not in stone, but and I've got some numbers to show you as well. Can you show the ones for the 10 cents and how that runs over 30 years? And we'll compare some of the numbers. I think that's a law for you. But we're going to show how it compares over the years. You're looking at additional, approximately 5.5 to 6 cents addition to what we pay now.
So you're talking about 16 cents.
16 cents. It's only the 5.5 to 6 cents additional we pay now. You're going to see it go up. It's only because.
Does the summary sheet be best or just the
10 cents? Just the 10 cents. First, let's just look at that if you don't mind. And you'll see it go up to the CPIU that's going to be attached to it. keep in mind that you're still looking at the 5.5 to 6 cents increase only, and that would be, in my opinion, for the lease of the pipe that we bring our raw water through. And this is just for reference points here. First, you look at your 10 cents and how it goes up. You look at your bottom line over 30 years with the numbers. You may want to handwrite that number down, because that would bring up other ones you'll be able to compare them to. Put your 10 cents down, and then next to it over the 30 years, times the 30 years, you've got a total of what, sir?
34 million plus.
34 million, right, going right the number down,
180.054. That's 30 years.
That's 30 years.
What's the 180 represent?
I'm sorry?
You said 180.
Oh, it's 34. I'm looking at the number.
34,180,000. And I have some hard copies.
Just bear with me on these numbers. I'm going to go back over and see the totals in a minute.
It's on this sheet here.
That's item one, and I've got four items to go over. I'm proposing to at least write up all rear view again one more time and consider them. We'll show the one that has 16 cents now, please. Watch your number, how it grows quite a bit. Still 30 year.
Starts at 16. Goes down to 2.
Yeah, but you're good. This part raises it 5.5 cents. Over 30 years.
That's what it says.
You went 21 cents. Am I on the wrong side?
No. Oh, are you on the right one?
Well, I started at 16. I checked.
Okay, sorry.
That's right.
You did start at 16, but is it line 55? Is that the same line?
No, that's wrong.
Hold on.
You're right. Got something.
That may be for the...
Is that 15?
20. We've got like 4 or 5 scenarios.
It should be 54. This is
Hang on.
That's the wrong.
The 71 should be 54.
That's correct. I've got a summary that I.
What line is it on?
50. You should be looking at, and I'll have to do this total.
Can you read that out? 54
should be
million what?
Thanks, somebody.
Should be 54,688,000. And $86. That's 546,880,086.
That's right. So you're looking at a difference there of about 19.5 million. So if you're looking,
What is it again, Tim?
54,688,086.
Keep in mind, your CPIU is going to compound a little bit greater than 60 cents. So it's not all going forward and leasing the pipe.
So it's a 20.
That's right. See what I'm getting at? All right. And then just for reference point, let's go ahead and, if you don't mind, show the 19 cent one. I'm not showing these because I want all these. I'm showing these so you see the difference on how much increases it as you go up just a few cents each time or 4 cents each time.
The total again, I had some rows hidden, and so the total was wrong. It should be 64 million.
What 64? The 16 cents?
19 is 64,942,102.
942,102. I mean, look how it increases each time. It's another 10 million.
Let me.
That's over 30 years.
That's over 30. That's correct. Well, let me
just interject something real quick, because these numbers are important. I want to bring it back around to something we did yesterday, just to bring this into perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday,
I'm going to show that too, by the way.
We were given on another agenda item some internet access or switches or something. What was that?
Sorry, AT&T.
Okay, so Metro Ethernet, AT&T's put in the infrastructure, they sell that service. We approved a contract, basically as given to us, because according to Donna Cooper, we're the only company that provides that service. Now, I've been contacted by two already to provide that service and would like to quote on it. But we were told it was the only service. Let's set the contract as it is, and we paid the price. We don't own part of the switches. We don't own any of that. We're purchasing a utility from them. Ethernet, internet, electricity, water, all that's utilities. I think that it's interesting to me that here we sit in a very similar situation with an entity, an enterprise fund, that's owned by the city of Covey, that has spent millions of dollars on infrastructure. They own it. They did it. They're giving us a price. Yet we continue to worry about what the city's doing instead of trying to determine what is the best price we can get for our customers. The proposal that Commissioner Cam presented for us yesterday had a $22 million savings over 10 years. Right? 11 years, something like
that. I want to show that.
What more savings do we need? I mean, how much more? I mean, we get so hung up on this pipe in the lake, and who owns it, and who gets this, and who gets that. How much more savings do we need for the customers? Do we need to get the city to pay us? Well, because you're still talking about leasing the pipe and everything. We're not in that business. It's not an availability. We're buying raw water.
Well, yesterday y'all brought that up. Mr. Camp specifically said this is a way to pay for without paying for all at
once. I don't believe it. We have to wait and look at the video. You suggested that. I'm suggesting that when you negotiate contracts, if you're a small user of a product, you pay the street rates. If you're a large user, you might have capital contributions to get a lower cost. If I'm a fuel distributor, I might agree to pay for part of a tank storage so that I can get a better price on a long-term contract. That's all normal. And I'm just going to ask this board, as we do this, to quit worrying about ownership. We need to ensure that we can get water through the intake. But this notion of who owns it, and they've made so much money off of us, you guys, we can't fix what previous boards did. But our job is to get this water contract done, is to get a fair price for our citizens. We provide plenty of water for them, and we can do that. But we've got to get past this spitefulness of what the city's done over the last 20 years. We can't change that, and we're not going to own that intake.
Yeah, but the difference is AT&T is not good.
That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. No, it doesn't. They're regulated by the government.
Not by the city.
Jim, you want this to go to court, so you don't have to
make a decision. You got your reason. You had your chance to explain all the things that you didn't think were differences.
Okay.
Now I ought to be able to get a chance to point out some things that are differences.
That's
also, based on your reasoning, I'd be happy to re-look at the Ethernet contract and try and get the price down, especially if there are competitors, which I didn't know about.
I'd like to add to it all, if I may. You're right, we own nothing of AT&T.
Right.
And the water, we have 40 million gallons a day from it. We have a finishing plant. We have pipes to bring it there and deliver it. We have a lot. What we don't have is an intake pipe.
But we have computers and switches
but we have
and
some.
Servers that we've invested in that we have to buy that Ether switch, Ethernet, whatever that is. So what I'm saying is, let's get past that.
Okay.
Fair enough. 21 cents, please. Okay. Thank you.
May have to read what I.
That's right.
I think we're working with different versions of Excel between my computer. Some of the cells are hidden. Someone's okay. Popping up here.
All right. So 20 cents.
I've got the I've got the right numbers.
That's right. 20 cents. 21.
Started at 21. And that number should be 71,778,113. That was an additional 5 years.
And would you mind showing what it comes to over 30 years for the amount that was started yesterday at 45 cents? Do you have that for
the city's?
Yesterday's contract was not a 30-year contract.
I understand. Well, I'm just trying to show what happened. It started at 45 cents.
But it's not an accurate.
Just
apples to apples.
It's, we're gonna run it for 30 years to see. You can discard it.
It's smoke and mirrors, that's not fair.
It's not smoke and mirrors.
It's not accurate. We didn't have a 30-year contract.
The whole idea was a short-term contract so you can renegotiate after 10 years.
That's the problem. You set a standard on what you're willing to pay, a 45 raise to this, you renegotiate, it's gonna start from there and just keep climbing. And that is reality. And I'm gonna show you what happens, if that's what happens, it should, it's not the savings that you're planning.
We can have our own intake by then.
This was a 10 or 12 year.
Let them show the numbers.
Well, it's not accurate. Go ahead and show it, it doesn't mean anything.
Show the numbers, because we started the 45 cents y'all proposed yesterday, you know, for the same 30 years.
But we weren't, the proposal wasn't for 30 years. Why don't you just say 50 years?
I understand, because I'm showing 30 years from the other ones to do apples to apples.
It's not apples to apples.
The bottom line is, if it stops at 12, you renegotiate. When we stopped at this contract we have today at 25, we can't even get them to start out of the finishing numbers, start from there again.
Sure we can.
Look what they're sending back to us.
They're at 225,000, we're at 243.
But they're making it up on the raw water.
So count it.
Way over.
Then count it.
I'm just gonna show the numbers that you brought.
It's not accurate.
Yesterday you offered 225, buying 1.2 billion.
Right.
And then you threw these numbers in.
For 10
it's gonna show how astronomically crazy it is.
Well, it went for 30 years.
Let's sell it for 50 years, because that's what we sent over there.
I would like to do something similar to what we sent over the other day. If we have to tweak a little bit, fine, or take their contract.
If you want
to
do it for 30 years.
Take their contract and make a couple of changes to it and send it back.
If you want to do it for 30 years, I don't propose 45 cents a thousand.
I wouldn't either.
What would you propose with these numbers that you're seeing now? Which one would you feel comfortable with?
I would have to think about it.
What's the wrong side?
I thought what we could do is have an option to walk away from this in 12 years if in fact we're getting our own permit, building our own plant.
Having raw water, if the numbers are right through them, you don't need to walk away from them. You don't need a secondary source. They're going to need a secondary source based on failure someday. Right. That's reality.
Then why don't we start with something that works? Why don't we start with the existing contract? What if we just tweaked the existing contract?
If it was.
What if you just said a five-year option on the finish at 225?
Can I read what I have then?
Hold on a second. Five-year option at 225, mm-hmm. and on the raw water, why don't you just try to go as is for 10 years and pay the 11.4 or 12 years, as I suggested, and at 10 cents a thousand.
Hold on, pay the what?
Pay the 11.4 at 10 cents a thousand. Or build or finance it, whichever way you want to go. Mr. Grover likes to finance it.
At 16 cents, it pretty much does that.
Okay, over 30 years. But why don't you do it over 10 or 12?
Because once you do that, you don't have guaranteed use that pipe for the cheap water rates.
Then give yourself an option.
Yourself in the foot.
Then give yourself an option.
Wait a minute. What's the
say 12 years and 45 like I proposed. And then the pipe, then the 11.4 is paid for, and then give yourself an option to freeze the CPI for the next 10 years, if that's what you want.
Also, you can't stay at 45, you got to drop it back down to your 10 cents or 14 or 15 cents, because you're no longer paying for a lease of the pipe. It's been paid for, and it should be for life at that point. You paid it at 11.4.
Then make that as your counter. Take the 12 year that I proposed,
mm-hmm.
and then at the end of 12 years, that's essentially what I was saying. Only it's not an option. I just said you walk away after 12 years.
But your purpose of 12 years was your numbers had the pipe paid for, and the infrastructure inside.
My purpose after 12 years was that you didn't have to pay the 11.4.
Because you already just paid it. That's why
you didn't have to pay the 11.4.
Because it was in the 45 cents. Just admit it. Make this
clear. Doesn't make any difference. Right, you're not going to get a receipt for the 11.4. You're just not paying.
I got you.
You're not
financing.
You're just not making a capital contribution.
But you are paying it through a lease or whatever you want to call it.
It's no different than if you're paying Shell.
I'm not saying it's bad or good. I'm just saying it did.
I'm
saying the price for raw water is going to be more if you don't pay the 11.4
up front. We don't make a capital contribution. You're going to pay more for raw water. It's not financing.
I think they've said that all along. Haven't they said they're going to raise the price of raw water if you don't pay the 11.4?
Yes, until they get their money, one way or the other. Just admit it. It's fair. It's okay that they get it.
If they want a capital contribution to give a better rate on water, that's fine. If they want to just have a rate, that's fine too. That's commerce, even though it's government. It is commerce. They're enterprise fund.
I don't have a problem with that. I say just say that's what you're doing. That's all.
But I'm not suggesting we finance it.
if you're paying them, anything over the 10 cents is giving additional money, and what is it for? Tell me that.
Because they have.
It's because the contract is expired.
Yeah.
That's what it's for.
No, because they've made a capital investment.
You're offering them 450% increase because the contract expired. You're offering that stuff.
We're renegotiating the contract. They have put, they have put investment in infrastructure. They're going to recover that.
So just say that. It's simple.
I just did.
They are recovering it.
Now, why don't you get past it, and why don't we just stick to what?
I can now that you, he said it. Would you admit he said it this time? You admit it, you said, I don't think he said it.
I don't agree with it. All
right, I need to see, you have your copy of your numbers from yesterday with you today.
You didn't lose the sheet I handed you.
It's in here. I might have. I thought it was so bogus, I didn't mind.
No, he called it garbage.
Oh, sorry.
What's your turn?
Because you weren't saying the truth about the numbers and what they're based on. I just want to know what they're based on.
They're based on a proposal, Tom.
I get it now, but
if you don't support, it was the only one proposal was laid out here yesterday. You didn't bring one to the table. You had a counteroffer come across from the city of Cumming. I brought a counteroffer back, and you didn't bring one yourself. So well, if you don't want to bring one, let's take this as a starting point and work on it.
Instead of worrying about
the board's preference was not to get tied into a long-term deal and to pay for raw water over the long term, because we were marching down trying to get our own permit from EPD. We have property on Pilgrim Mill Road, and we wanted to put our own intake in. So this allows us to walk away clean. It gives us a water solution for the next 10 years.
I'm trying to find the years we get a total number for the raw water only at that price where it totals up. I don't think we have it combined with the finished water. I'd like to have that breakdown and see what the difference is between the 10 and 9.
Does that mean you're willing to consider this proposal?
That
it's not garbage anymore?
I'm willing to consider getting the infrastructure, our share paid, whatever that fair share is, and then lowering it back down. We're just paying for raw water again, for the infrastructure.
Then just put an option on the end of this. At the end of 12 years,
I tried to say that yesterday. That we retro back. You said we don't want to go past 12. I'm not going to do that. I tried to do that yesterday. It's funny how we have to argue to get to the same solution eventually anyways.
I'm not arguing with you. I'm telling you, go ahead and put that on as an option at the end, if that's what you want. That's called negotiation.
Tim, can I have one of the printouts that you did for the 10 cents, please, just a handout? I want to see if you have the same amounts of gallons.
Well, what I have so is, I've got the summary that we just...
I just want to see what the gallons are. Make sure that before we could guess it has the same numbers.
It may not show the gallons on the summary.
Yeah, it's a bow and arrow. It's a bow and arrow or a club. Little John is a club, too.
Little John is a big one.
Since they're looking at it, let's just get it.
Okay.
I don't think you're showing gallons on this.
No, I did not. I tried to show them the numbers.
You have?
I did. I can get it.
That's still
the same on any of them.
I need a gallon.
Are we back to what this is yesterday's camp or
not? Is this what you did it off of? You're starting on the gallons here. Did you start off the same off of those as yours?
It's 32 million, 3.2 million
a year.
Do you guys want to add up year by year
for help?
Well, we can do that. It's only 11 numbers.
This was, I believe, where we started yesterday.
Are you able to go in there and redo that, please?
Would you want the number on the gallons?
Whatever they ran yesterday, starting at the 45 cents on the same gallons.
That would be this one right here.
For 12 years, we had 12 years.
We had 6 years. This deal had 6 years of finished water, which was 1.2 billion a year. 225, and the raw water started at 45 cents.
All right.
This is the one that Commissioner Town that we
had. Right.
We're
with you. And this went for 10 years, but captured 20 months previous.
And we had 10 years is highlighted in bold here.
Because we... How are you going to pay them that money if you go retro back in 3 years? That's not going to be a cash or a capital? Is that your proposal?
It could, or we could raise the raw water rate if you want to. I thought maybe we'd just take 20 months and 45 cents a thousand. And
20 months?
Yeah, that would be about $2 million. 2.6, I think I came up with. But we, you know, we have to acknowledge we've been using the intake for 20 months.
Why are we just navigating the bill?
This was a previous version.
We were using the intake based on the fact that we had a contract. We never asked for the petition. In fact, we were not even consulted on the old contract. No, that's not true. We had water all this time. We paid $800,000 to continue to have water. It is possible if we have a horrible drought that the old intake would not have supported it.
The old intake did not support.
It did not support. They had emergency pipes.
And they built, and
they had emergency pipes, which we paid for. But the emergency went away, and we could have continued on the old intake.
Yes, but think about this. Had they not put that intake in at that time when the lake was low, it would have cost more money to put it in than the $17 million that they put it in. It probably would have cost, I mean, significantly more.
A lot of people can criticize people for all the things, but you cannot criticize the city for the foresight that they had in the 70s to get into the ordinance, or to go build this intake at, what is it, 1,070?
Are you able to get a total on that?
I can.
Yeah, just give me a
raw water.
Yeah, 12 years.
10 years?
No.
I don't have the previous two.
And I'm glad too. I just
don't have the last two.
Well, you're going to have to step up just two extra, that's all. And we just, you know what I'm saying, just know you're going to retro back the first two. Okay, just pick up 12.
Okay. So we got this.
32?
Yeah.
I think that was in there on cost to the city. Or maybe
well, I didn't have the 2 years prior.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. That's what I was saying, trying to add this up. You say, oh, wait for all the time. I can't see it.
Now, the raw water total, is that what you're looking for?
Raw cost, water. Yes, 12.
Raw water cost is on there.
The total for the 12. You don't have a total, sir. At 29. Now, is it possible for you to go back to the 10 cents? I'm sure I'm after here in a minute. 10 cents and do a same 12 year window for it. I want to see what the difference is so we can see what extra they're going to be getting if it's enough or too much.
And it's really not 2 years, it's 20 months. But that's why, that's how I came up with that number.
Fair enough.
So it's a little bit off.
Fair enough. If we both keep doing this for 4 more months, we'd be right on.
That's right. And you know what? I was thinking about that this morning. Now I look forward to sitting here for 4 more months.
I was not
arguing about that.
5 o'clock in the morning, I woke up thinking how much I don't want to.
That's one too many. That's 13 okay. Years.
All right.
The bottom staying 13. So I believe that's what I did on the other. Check that. It's Well, that's 13 rows. Okay, I got you. That's correct. That's 12.
You got it? So 6,561.
Yes, 13 rows count total.
871. And that's where it hits the fan. Look at the difference. It's 23 million, not 11.4.
Pardon me?
It's $23 million difference, not 11.4. 12 years on yours, 12 years of what we pay today. It's a difference of.
So why don't
$23 million, not 11.4.
So why don't you just come up with a new number simply on that raw water that's reasonable? Tim, put in a quarter.
Okay, does that take into effect 10 cents
right
we already pay?
Raw water.
In this cop right here.
The difference between 45 and 10 cents is 35.
Okay, so if I take that out, that's taking out 6.5.
How about that, Todd?
So instead of 23, you're going to be down somewhere around 17. Still 4 million too much.
How about a quarter?
Yeah, might not be enough for your 12 years if that's what you're trying to accomplish. I'll be fair that way, too.
Then put in 30 cents, Tim.
And this is just for the 12 years, and then it shuts back down to what?
It's renegotiated.
I don't want to renegotiate. No.
Maybe it's
renewable. If we're coming up with the money, it needs to be, from that point forward, it needs to continue another 20 years.
Put an option on it.
Not 10 year option.
I'll
go for that.
I want a total of 30 for paying for income.
So 10 and 10.
Three 10 year options.
That's very close.
And it needs to drop back down to a starting number.
So you want to renegotiate it for a future board?
Well, what are you talking about? We just did a 25-year contract. How many boards went
through? No, I'm saying if it's a 10-year, 10-year, and a 10-year, then it renews. It's a 10-year, it's renegotiated, and the board in 10 years can negotiate whatever they want.
There's no way. If you're planning for this now,
all right, so it's a 10-year.
You guarantee a very fair rate to continue.
Then it's a 10-year with a 10-year option.
I want a total of 30.
So 10 and a 10, or 15 and a 15.
When you say that you're paying for the intake, you say we're paying for it in the uplift on the 10 cents?
Yes.
Okay.
And so why don't you do 15 and 15?
Take into account the two we've already used, so really take it out 13 years from now and 15 years from now.
So let's do the 25 cents for 15, so that doesn't come back to it.
Sir?
Sorry, we keep bothering you so much.
Take line 32.
Line 30.
Go down to 15 years. What is that going to be? 27?
Okay, I'm gonna take this out and go 15 years.
Go out 15, please. Yeah. Just delete that line and insert one or move it over.
And this is a 25 or 30?
And we're going to go to.
This is a.
What's 15 years? It's 2027?
Right there. After this, we'll insert.
2026, I think.
Is it insert above or below? I can't remember.
It'll go above. Okay. And now, total left raw water cost.
16 years.
That's 16 years, that's right.
30.
That's 16 years?
Yes, it is. It's one too many.
Yeah. I think you're right. I think it's one too many.
If you almost get the number, you're going to be very close then.
Just cut it.
You missed the top one? Does it matter?
It's highlighted.
Okay.
You should.
What is it?
That is
27.
15 years.
Yeah. That gets real close now. A lot closer to what you had.
Closer
to having the number to pay sure of anything. And if you'll do the same 15 years, I just want to see the difference. The same 15 years on the 10 cents we're going to be today. And then we have to calculate yours, like you said.
Hold on just a minute. That's 27.
27,806.
Or you can simply do it.
What is it? 27?
I think
806, 721.
I think a couple things need to be kept in mind. If you're going to calculate raw water costs, we're assuming that we have the facilities in place now to treat it. And there comes a quantity when we don't.
This is just working this
out. If you buy it, you might not, I mean, at some point your plants hit capacity. And I think that it's
we may not need to be talking about above that capacity, which is going to be, once this plant comes online, we're going to have 14 at best. Probably just ought to call that 12 for our existing plant. And how much on the new plant?
12.
So you're talking about, once you get above 25 million gallons, you don't have a plant to treat it. So do you build another plant? Do we have the land to build it?
But we're still at 18.4 when we're at the truck.
Yeah, I know, but if you just...
Which is another reason why it doesn't make sense to pay for the...
We're looking at raw water cost. And I'm trying to say that if you're going to look at raw water costs, at some point you're going to put another $20 or $30 million into another plant, you need to factor that into raw water costs.
Yeah, but we're still at 18.4 average.
Okay, where?
In 2025. Tim, move over to the AA.
Okay, is that number accurate?
Tim, go left. No.
Do your AA.
Total water needed.
Oh, right here.
Yeah.
18.45 MGD, that's average.
That's correct. That's annual average demand that we will need.
And we can treat 20.
So we're good.
But you need
24. You've got to bump that times 1.6 to get
the peak.
Number.
But we can also still buy finished water from the city at that point.
That's correct.
Well,
what is it?
You don't have a guaranteed source after 2017.
You do a lot of this.
We're done at 18.45.
Well, we're probably, city and county together are about the 37 before any of these. So something else has to happen.
We've got to get our permit increased.
Something has to happen.
Regardless.
We've got to get this settled and then get our permit increased. We really need to quit worrying about what the city's permit is and go get our permit increased. Again, we're too worried about what the city's permit is. Who cares what theirs is?
Which is the reason why we shouldn't pay for the whole intake till we get the permits.
We're not, this is a pay as you use. It wouldn't be paid for. We're not paying off writing the check. Yeah, we're not going to pay for anything.
What's that?
I think nobody's saying writing the check.
We're not paying for it. We're not making
payments. Well, now I'm with Todd. I mean, you can pay him with a check, or you can pay him in, let's say, raw water. You're still paying him. Why pay the 100%?
Why not
tie it to the amount he'd have?
Is there a number? Can you go to the right, and is it computing how much total cost per gallon? Okay, so cost of water, we're dropping down to under a buck a gallon.
With CPI figured in there. Absolutely.
And?
Again, we're hung up on this intake.
And right now, Gwinnett County will sell it to us for what, $340?
Gwinnett, I don't know. Gwinnett's...
Right now, we're paying $225 in Fulton County.
Correct.
That's a fact.
That's a $43 million savings. Again, gentlemen, how much more do we need to sell?
By chance, do you have calculated the increase of chemicals and such over the years?
It's built into the...
Into the formula?
I don't know the exact number. Power and chemicals, I built in 2% annual increases on chemical and power. I doubt power goes up.
$43 million savings. How much more? How much do we want the city to pay us to take this work? I mean, I think that's where it's going.
How much will that?
I don't know. Why don't you run across and talk to us?
What was your idea?
No, I'm just wondering, what's the number you want to save? Give me a number.
Treating water.
Well, I like the deal where it was 10 cents and we paid them, about 60 cents per thousand for the raw.
Well, we're not living in Wampa land. We're living in Forsyth.
Well, you asked me.
Well, let's have realistic.
60 cents for the raw for how long?
You said 10 cents for the raw.
I mean, you said 60
cents for the finished.
Let's live in the real world. I mean, let's not live in the fantasy land.
That's what we can finish it for, right? 60 cents.
But again, you might be able to...
All right, we were almost getting somewhere.
Produce gasoline.
We are. We're going to get back on track again.
I think that maybe we're...
We were getting somewhere. You got up.
What's wrong with this right here?
Yes, sir. You distracted everybody.
What's up with this?
Give me way too much credit.
What's wrong with this proposal right here?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it.
What's wrong with it?
I'm concerned that we don't have enough. Tim, you guys help me out. If you go over to the left, and we're still at the $1.2 billion. For 6 years.
Well, you didn't let me get to my number two yet.
I was just you.
It addresses.
I'm answering his question. He asked me what's wrong with it. Tim, do you think we have enough water?
Only if we're allowed to treat the extra additional water at our plant. if we can't get that, the city's permission, that's critical to get permission for them to let us treat part of their, it's their raw water, but we get the trees.
We need them to give us part of their allocation, my proposal.
Then this, we can survive.
Hold on, Todd.
Then we can survive with this, but if we're, it depends on how we have to take it too. If we have to take it every single day instead of averages, that can, it's hard to know.
The 1.2 billion, Brian, if you would allow me to, we'd be on the same thing we're doing out of sand. Take it kind of when we need it. What about if we go out at, I don't see the year there, line 26. What if we, you know, we still have the ability to buy finished water? The last proposal we had, Brian, was they would make available 6.5 MGD.
Mm-hmm.
So we add that into this new proposal.
That's in here.
Is that going to do it, Tim? 6.5 million a day, 30-day average?
Yes, and that's basically what we can get today. There's going to come a time when our plant may have the extra capacity, and the city's plants don't. That's where we need that flexibility. When they bump up against their permit max, we may want to be able to treat the additional and not get
those are all operating synergies that you can work out with their director, not necessarily on the cost issues, but I think that this
6.5 would get us what we're getting from them today during peak times.
On 30 days.
Let's just say, though, that they expand Northside Hospital even further and they don't have extra water for us. Do we need to lock down some more water from them?
I think a 6.5 MGD on a 30-day average is. I don't want to lock that into a guaranteed purchase. And I think the city's agreeable to have that available.
And I don't mind have locking down to some guarantee in the months that make sense.
All right. So can we do this then with the 5-year option after this on the finish?
We'll do what?
I mean, if we're going to move forward along these lines with that 1.2 at 225, can we say we need... we ask for a 5-year option, Tim? Would you think that's a good idea?
An additional 5.
As an option?
As an option.
That always is.
Sure. As an option. As well. Or, or 6.5 MGD.
No, 6.5 million, definitely.
Yeah.
And if we get a 5-year option, it includes the 6.5 million.
Correct.
It works best for us to be able to get more in the summer months than the winter months.
All right,
to
so
have
the would
normal
you think the 1.2 billion a renewal of the? See, I don't like the minimum purchase requirement, although I understand that.
No, I don't. Y'all talk about things already in here.
Okay,
they're already in here. When you did your proposal that day, did you not? You shut me down one time. I let you finish. Did I not?
Yeah, but we're all discussing, not just me. We'll give you credit for it. It's okay.
I don't want
we'll
that. I want to finish reasoning the proposal to you. Y'all discussing exactly what already covered.
What is the raw water proposal that you have? So are you going with what we had yesterday?
So far, what you're discussing, if you want to go with the 12 to get them what you need to, and then it drops back down to a certain number, that's whatever it is, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, then I'm okay with that for additional 15.
And I like a 15, like we have it right here.
You need to do an additional 15 after
with
that.
With that 15 renewal.
Not at that same number.
Just keep on trucking.
No, because then
look at what the cost is, Todd. It's less than $1.
They've already got their money there. You already gave them their money.
You're so,
so
you're
27
worried
million.
About it.
So what do you want to reset the water to at the 15 years?
Whatever 10 cents would have been on.
Yeah, but by then, 10 cents probably won't cover.
He can calculate CPI up to 15 years, whatever that number is, where you can start it, or a little bit more. But to leave it at that and let it keep climbing is crazy.
We're under $1 for
it doesn't
water matter.
It's your water with
no
permit.
Capital contribution.
Yes, you just gave it to them. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
With no
at the 45
upfront,
cents.
No upfront capital contribution.
But you gave it to them.
And they're responsible for everything.
Why don't you go ahead.
Go ahead, do your thing. Have at it. You're just so worried about somebody.
Let me go. Shut up and let me go. What are you doing?
Go.
I want you to make a proposal.
Well, be quiet. Don't say go 5 more times. Good Lord. You guys just a minute ago said that our plan yesterday was 45 cents. and if you did it for 12 years, he'll have the money for the intake. And I said, great, we need to go back to what would have been standard then. He already had his money filled by it. If you're going to keep paying him, I just soon pay cash and start at 10, 12 cents.
Such a motion.
No, I'm not giving you a motion. I'm going to my proposal, Little John. And y'all have 1.2 billion, but I don't care. It could be 1 billion or 1.2 billion. And no purchase required November through February. You can put, and then of course the rest of the gallons are out on the months you need them through the months you need them. Y'all disagree with that? You said yourself.
I don't agree with that.
You don't want to buy it when you have to buy it the other months?
I don't want to go with an unlimited thing like that. I want
just
to
buy it when you buy it.
1.2 billion annual purchase, just like it is now. We buy it when we need it.
Fair enough.
None of this other nonsense in there, because if we do need it, then you've set it up where we can't buy it.
Fair enough. The raw water for 30 years, however you want it, give them the 11.4, I don't care. You want to get the first 10 years or 15 years, then it needs to reset back down to what the rate is today.
11.4 what?
With the CPI figured for that time frame.
What, 11.4 what?
I got to tell you, that's just very vague. So
that's why I just assumed, because okay. See, I'm afraid you guys
can you just clean
this.
It up a little bit?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I will. Because if you give them 1.4, it cleans it up a lot, and you're done.
But
you stay at 10 cents.
But our director of finance, and I will tell you, as being on the Water and Sewer Committee, I know that we do not have that
11.4 million.
It'll cause us to have to rework our entire capital improvement plan.
So
we don't have it.
The 10 cents, did you ever give me the 10 cents at 15 years like you? Back to
that's what this is.
The 30 cents that we were thinking about.
Here, this was 30 cents. We
just did it 10 cents also, if you will, please.
Let's change here. This was 10 cents for
30,
for 15 years.
For 15 years.
9 million.
And what's the ending number? 14.1? That's what you start out at, gentlemen.
14.1. I want to wait until he gets the whole thing.
I understand.
Let's go ahead and let him put his package together.
Yeah, is that 9 million? Is that correct?
Yeah. 9 million, 200.2.
268?
907. Yes.
All right. That number differs from the 30 cents Mr. Bell suggested is about 21 million. I'm sorry, it's not that much either. It's about 18. Million?
18 plus.
Measure intake plus interest and anything else. And of course, we'll let Mr. Gwynn figure out more exact. Because you may have to be at 29 cents or 28 cents. And you
there's your intake. You have to explain that. You got a number there at 9.2.
Then that is for what we're paying today at 15 years at 10 cents.
Okay.
At 30 cents, it was 27,806. So your difference is about 18 million. How much is the intake? 11.4? Our share, so they say. So there's your money. And of course, Mr. Brewer can adjust that 30 cents, maybe 20 or 29, to be closer to a real number, plus figuring interest since we're somewhat financing it.
So you're taking, starting at 10 cents, and you're taking 30 additional cents to 40 cents? Is that correct?
Because you want me to work the 10 cents out of there? What he's
saying is we're not counting the 10 cents we're already paying in the 30 cents.
But I did by taking it out at the 9.2. I just did that. That's why I ran the 10 cents in 15 years. It gives you the 9.2. Subtract that off of what 30 cents gives you, 27.8, and that leaves you the 27 cost difference. Is that correct, Mr. Green?
I'm sorry, there's just a comment here. I'm sorry, the last one. The initial 20 cents gave you 18 million more.
Okay. The 20 cents gives you 18 million more.
The 20 cents?
Extra. If you go over 10 cents, it gives you the 18 million more. Does that not cover 11.4?
Yes, but the 10 cents is a true cost. Are you capturing that?
I understand that.
So what is your, on year one, what is your raw cost of water for 1,000 gallons going to be? What do you propose?
30 cents.
30 cents. Okay, let's put that up there.
We have that, it's 27.80.
Why don't we have a spreadsheet up there where we plug this in?
Before you erase that out, please, one thing. All right, see the 10 cents at the end of 15 years? Is 0.141. That's your starting point at 15 years. It resets back to that after they've had the money for the intake.
It's your operating cost.
That's operating cost. If you want to go a little bit more, start a couple cents, so be it. But that's a point of starting.
Okay.
But you've already paid for your intake over the first 15.
Out of the raw.
So now you reset back down to what it would have been if it was 10 cents the whole time with the CPIU.
All right, so what about, after 15 years maintenance, that sort of thing?
That's
how do we know what the storage fees are going to be for the Army Corps? How do we know?
We know.
Okay.
We know.
But so why don't you take
that? But you're looking at 18 million instead of 11.4.
Why don't you take that a little higher than 14, say, just so you're covered?
And that's fine.
So take it to 20.
That's a lot.
What if you started at 20 after year 15? 20 cents a thousand?
That seems fair. Now,
20 cents a thousand for all water for 15 years
now? I probably live with it.
Why don't we reset that, the cost as plus 50%? That's what 14, 15 cents is. It's 10 cents plus 50 to 0.5. So why don't we take the anticipated, instead of trying to come up with a number that we don't have a clue. That concrete could collapse on that thing, which would cost them maybe 7,000.
That's a capital improvement. It would be given that we would have to contribute if that
happens.
Not
at the higher prices, not at the 30 cents.
Not during that first 15 years.
But the second time,
I think you have a good shot at 20 cents a thousand in 15 years.
And then you'll have a clause in that we share in the capital improvements.
Of course.
After year 16. Okay.
Additional capital improvements are necessary. Yeah.
With written approval in advance. Same clause we had in the other one is the city must request the EPD for approval allowance. Anyway, so we get their share of the raw water to treat in our plant, but we have to have the EPD approval, as Mr. Merritt, Mr. Perkins showed a while ago. And that's before. That's it.
All right, so the language on that last one, is that the same language that went over before?
No.
So you're saying they've got to give up their allocation?
Mr. Perkins said, no, that's not what it says.
I'm sorry, what's it say?
You're asking them to allow us to treat some of their portion of their raw water. Mr. Perkins says that we need to first get approval from EPD to be able to do that in our plan.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, though, you're asking for their allocation.
No. Just treating it to, no, we're not. Treatment, you have to have apparently a permit.
I think the EPD will accept the city's raw water in case they want it back, but I don't know that unless the city says, I'm going to allow for South County to treat part of my raw water at their plant, and the EPD is going to have to modify the two permits, the operational permits to do that, and it's just...
Okay, but
it's not giving, this goes back to
what I said before. What if they have a major expansion to that allocation? I mean, they're giving that water up. Like I said, what if Northside Hospital expands, Tyson's Chicken expands?
I've only, based on our professional, having it's a professional, because we've asked for them to give us some of their raw water, as Mr. Bell's alluded to, so we don't have to buy as much as the finished when we need it. We can actually treat ourselves. We're not legally allowed to do it unless they get permission, allow us to have permission from EPD. Otherwise, that's just smoke and mirrors on an agreement. We won't actually really get it. So if we really want to get it, our professional tells us this is what we have to do.
That's fine.
That's all. I'm not trying to be sneaky or anything, but if we're going to ask for it, you've got to have what you need to actually make it happen. That's that simple.
Okay, so let's go through the numbers from the start to finish.
Fair enough.
Number, the raw water cost. So are we leaving the finished alone at 1.2 billion at 225? 1.6 available on 30-day average?
I had in mind, just to be exact, and then we'll get back to that. I had it at 1 billion. You increase it 5% a year. And you're 5 and 5, just the way you said.
We need the water.
That's fine. 1.2 is better.
We need the water.
I agree.
225 is what we pay for.
That's correct. That's what I have here.
1 point. The average would be 6.5 available on a 30-day average. Is that what you need here?
But we won't. Don't want to have to buy it every day. Just as needed. And we know this much. 8 months a year.
Is
that okay?
Do you? Counselor, are you getting this? Because I think there's a motion to percolate.
Well, I am, and I'm wanting to make sure.
Well, I think we're going to go downstairs like you did the other day with me after we write all these notes down. That's fine. Type one up with me and Tim and come back up, and then we'll make the motion after everybody reads it and tweaks it.
That's fair enough.
And is comfortable with it.
Then let's get moving on that. I got a business to run.
Okay.
Go ahead, Counselor.
Just want to say, with respect.
It's 9 o'clock. You can start billing us now.
Nice. Thank you.
Is what? This on Possum TV, Brandon?
How'd you know?
Oh, man.
What is that there, Brandon?
Possum TV.
What is that? Does take.
Tripods are real dangerous, and I didn't have a hard hat or caution tape.
We should have made that floss, Brian.
Somebody please take a picture of that.
She got
it. It's actually designed to do like this right here for you guys. Now y'all keep going right there. Y'all went online.
You need some capital improvements, my friend.
Were you in Boy Scouts? We use a lot of duct tape.
Okay, that's for real.
Excuse me, Ms. Tisdale.
And you have the gall to call us rednecks.
Good old Possum TV.
You are killing me.
Is it 1.2 billion a minimum?
Yes, that stays the same.
That's
1.2 billion, 225,000
annual.
6.5 million available on 30-day average.
I got that, but I just want to make sure it's a minimum required purchase of finished water on an annual basis.
On a 30-day average.
Grant, you need a PayPal link.
We need something there that allows to buy a little more if needed, don't you think?
That's what the 6.5 is.
Okay, it's the minimum.
Which is what you had to ask for.
Can sell us more.
That's what
it
is.
That minimum.
Okay.
Do you have a minimum
Okay.
Are you playing golf today?
I think I look better than the lights down. Thanks a lot, guys.
Hold it. What? We'll see what goes.
All right.
So then I guess on the raw water, we're starting at, did you say 30 cents?
I'm okay with 30 cents.
30 cents for 15 years.
For 15 years. CPI used in it, yeah.
CPI.
You.
For Metro Atlanta. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then after, at year 16, our option.
No, I'm sorry, 20 cents.
Drops back to 20 cents. CPI again, I guess.
Yes.
15 more years.
Is that an optional renewal or?
I think it should be. I don't want to make it their option to renew it or not. It needs
no. It'd be our option to renew it.
Yes. They have to accept if we choose to opt in.
What else?
Number four was the verbiage.
That has nothing to do with the spreadsheet.
No, it doesn't have to do.
Can you just go over to the right, Tim, and see what the cost of water is going to be? Treated water.
Good grief.
And the total cost. Just go over a little bit. So the cumulative savings over 15 years is $44 million.
I don't know if that's in it.
I don't know either.
I don't even, this is just...
Let's take that and put it in the employee pension.
I'm not even going to that way. I'm going what we do today, what they're asking for to help pay for the intake, and I'm trying to accommodate those with them.
Because you'll be here that long. Looking at your last...
Exactly. For any little repairs or something, no, exactly. I agree. But we're close for it, Mr. Grill.
Yeah, I think so.
I think so too.
You're close to what?
Covering any interest involved in that, getting a little bit extra. But I mean, you know, small minor repairs and stuff that we would normally have to pay, but we're saying we don't want to be responsible in that time frame, so.
I don't understand, if you cost per 1,000 gallons, why are we at 45? Is that include the finish? Is that what that is in line number 22? So your cost per 1,000 over the left. Left. Right there. You were there. One more over to the right.
To the right.
Okay.
There you go.
This is a calculation of our cost at our plant. It takes what it's going to cost us to treat this amount of water based on labor maintenance. No depreciation, no included in these.
Okay.
And so power and chemicals. That's what it cost us to treat this many gallons of water, and that's a formula.
Okay.
And it's not true.
You've got a little
that's
economy.
A calculated.
You have an economy of scale there because of.
Yes.
The more we treat,
the more we. That's why it doesn't really go up. The more we treat, the chemicals go up and the power go up. But and labor is pretty much fixed plus 3%.
I like it.
And we saw our own infrastructure.
Does that include the raw water costs?
That does not include the raw water costs. Okay. That's just our cost to treat. That's these columns here that are in this pinkish color.
Okay.
And then if you added in the raw cost, that'd be this column over here. And then that's what I divide the total by to get the average cost.
Okay.
Why don't you go take a trip?
Yeah. Take a break for a minute?
Well,
15 or 20?
All right, are we, the last time we did this, we basically just renewed the existing agreements. Is that your general structure as well?
Is there any way that we can take the city's offer and do some kind of a legitimate counter that butchering it by trying to do this back again? Just in good faith, do a real counter instead of throwing theirs in the trash can and redoing one the way they've done us four or five times now.
You mean take theirs and just plug it in under here? I think this
one's different. You're not going to change everything because they've got some things in there.
No, I'm saying take that one.
They take it inside. Like,
you can take this thing, just take theirs
and change a little bit of verbiage maybe.
So that way it's their contract instead of a new one from us.
And it just looks like we've done a legitimate counter on theirs, which we're trying to do. You may have to change a little bit of verbiage in there, you know.
I'm not sure what legitimate counter means.
It means take a contract off of you, change a couple things, send it back, and make you feel comfortable.
And if you don't do that, it's no legitimate counter.
No, instead of taking and throwing the trash can, just throwing another
one. We haven't thrown anything off the trash can.
Well, I know they've done it to us five times. I'm trying not to use that for any kind of double sports trackers.
You're very good.
Well, thank
you. Well, thank you for correcting me.
Let me answer that this way. It depends. I mean, this proposal does not have us paying a direct lump sum allocation for the intake, correct?
No, we're offering that.
All right, so that's a big chunk out of both the agreement we sent over and their response. All that comes out. Okay? All right, so that makes it
a lot different.
Well, it makes it easy. I mean, okay. Yeah, it makes it different. So yeah, I mean, there's going to be a lot of red, though. I mean, to the extent we send over a red line, it'll be very red.
Beautiful, colorful contract. Huh? Hey, or you can send one over.
However, I must say, I would love to have a bullet point presentation of what we're coming to here.
I'm not going to be able to put together an IGA and have it to you in 10 minutes. This is going to be a bullet point like we did last year.
Good.
You'll have something we can vote on.
I will have terms that you can vote on that I will then take over and put into an IGA before it goes across the street.
Can we also have Tim take the values of this bullet point just to create a spreadsheet that shows just, you know, that we clean up the spreadsheet. I'll be happy to do it to you guys. to have it still do it, but it's, that way we've got all those numbers to attach to it as an exhibit.
I don't think it's a shed.
Yeah, I'm just.
But you want to see, but I don't think I'm close.
No, it's not going to the city, it's for our discussion. Take the numbers that you guys are gonna plug in, and then we'll plug them into this spreadsheet and have that to go along with the bullet.
I've got one more question. I understand about no lump sum, I get that. With respect to the notion of going to EPD for joint permit allocation requests, is that not contemplated either?
Yes, it is, if they would support our efforts.
Okay, so some of the former verbiage we had in our old IGA.
That same language should just stay in.
What's that?
That same language.
From our old one as well.
I understand.
Yeah, we're gonna lay it both out.
Tidy all that up this year, new IGA.
Okay.
Is there any other issues we need to address that you can think of in that?
The biggest issue was, is when I put together the old IGA, I had to take out a lot of terms of the existing IGAs that no longer have any relevance or that have already been executed, like there's certain termination fees, there's certain costs. I still plan on doing that unless you tell me otherwise. I mean, I can't in good conscience send over one that's got terms that are confusing.
Certainly, Counselor, if you think it's going to butcher so terribly with red lines and then we'll at that moment, I guess, rewrite something different to see it, what it looks like.
Well, again, if you just tell me the moving parts, that's what I'll do the best I can to put it into a form.
Well, I think you start with a lot from what we created last time as far as that language.
And that was a darn good contract.
Of course.
I thought so.
Well, remove the thing.
Maybe we'll scare them so they're
comprehensive.
We've actually put it out there on wall.com and we're selling it to generate some.
All right.
Now it's after 9 o'clock. Go ahead.
Are you going downstairs?
Yes.
Was there an option on the finished water? There was.
Yes.
And you talked about a 5-year, but I did you have
five
an option?
Five-year option.
Five, yes. Okay, you did have.
Five and five. But I want to tell you on that spreadsheet, I think there's 6 years on it.
This is six. That's right.
That's where I started.
Yeah.
We'll go 5 and 5.
Six and three.
All right, we need to take a break.
What are we resetting?
We need 15 minutes, Mr. Chairman.
15? Come on now.
What do you do?
I will try to do it quicker than that.
You can do it in 5.
We're going over to Mr. Swenson.
No. Desire motion to
We need a motion to recess for 15. We will be reconvening is the point.
Want to say 9:30?
Yeah.
Give me an extra 5 minutes.
Yeah. Do I hear a motion to recess?
Second.
We have a motion to recess for till 9:30 and a second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Passes.
Doug, can we borrow your office?
Yes. Doug, can I borrow you then while they recess?
Yes.
Okay. And we were a
lot.
Can
you
step out?
There's some shops in that street.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, if
you,
I don't know if there's a
different one.
That's
why
it's
going
to
be. Switch the reading started.
Are we ready, Ken?
We are. So ready.
So ready.
We've been ready.
Couldn't be more ready.
Okay. You sit there, Jody. You have to vote for it.
Oh, no, I'm not voting. I was caught napping over there. My vote will be.
That picture will be all over
you. The people.
Of course,
I'll
read that all. They were all.
I'm old. That's the revolution.
You crush bonus too, don't you?
It's a great voice.
Don't distribute whenever you're ready. Or we can't.
All right, I'd like to call the special work session back in order, please. And I think that I've gotten the signals that I guess that you can. If I'm wrong about that, let me know. You've got at least bullet points.
We do.
I got one.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm.
that's different than what you said before.
We had to, and this is recommendation of your specialist. And
my specialist.
Yeah, your specialist. And every time they were, that's your specialist. Chop liver.
Are you going to be able to put this up on the screen?
The dollars are.
He was understood what you said.
I do not have that. Ken, that's what you can't have.
Do you have the thumb drive or something to put this up on the screen?
6.5 is. It was a 15 and a 15 year option.
We can, might need to just make a copy.
That's okay.
Anyway, some more coffee.
That's different.
No, and I always approach from a total overall.
You said 15 and 15 year option.
They have to give it up.
They?
They, the minds in the room.
Did we misunderstand something?
We said 15 years, 15 year option. That's a long way from 30 year.
On the fish, I'm raw.
On the raw.
Do you have a comment on that, Counselor, and how it?
Why do we need as-bills in engineering specs?
Just to be sure where what we've got, what the intake structure actually is, what the elevation, what's the pumps, what's the all those things that we're acquiring for the $14 million.
We're not acquiring.
We're not acquiring. We're getting a, for that document. We're getting the least interest in the intake.
I don't think that's what we talked about either. Is that what we talked about before? Nydia, back that video up.
Why wouldn't you want that? Why wouldn't you want some interest in that?
I'm not saying that, Commissioner. What I'm saying is that's not what we talked about. For you to go do bullet points. You want to change the entire agreement?
Ask them to do it for free.
I don't know why you think I'm going to do what we talked about. My issue is this is not what we talked about for them doing it.
That's all.
I wanted what we talked about, Commissioner.
But don't,
that's
you,
what
want,
I
don't you want to be clear that you're in for it and that they can't come back and hand you another
this
bill?
This is not what we're talking about.
Okay. Didn't we say 15-year, 15-year option?
This was counsel's recommendation.
Let me tell you something. These commissioners make the decisions, not the counselor.
We said 15-year, 15-year option.
These commissioners.
Is there anybody in this room or heard different?
These guys are specialists, and you have a reason why you have legal counsel. And so look out for your best interest when you're writing.
Our legal counsel does not go in and change what we
ask. Is this your idea, counsel?
The raw water component of this is a 15 and 15 year component with an option.
Okay, so why does it say the payment shall secure irrevocable 30 year leasehold? I mean, that's different than 15 year option. That's what we all heard. It was 15 years at 30, starting at 30 with a CPI, and then 15 years after that, coming down to 20 with the CPI.
And
is that in here anywhere?
I don't even see it.
Just somebody tell me
Is what in there?
That concept of 30 cents a thousand.
Yes.
For 15 years.
Yes.
And then an option of 20 cents a thousand for 15 more.
Yes.
Right there.
Yes.
That's in there.
But they're wrong.
Okay. But then why does it say at the top irrevocable 30 year leasehold?
Who came up with that idea?
That was not you?
Who came up with that?
That was a legal.
Well, then let's just cross it because they're not voting. Whoever came up with it doesn't vote on it.
So cross it off.
Is it something that's recommended by legal for us to keep in there to look out for our best interest?
It was trying to address the issue of what are we paying for?
We're not paying for anything.
You are.
We're buying raw water, and they have to provide raw water.
Then why are you paying 30 cents for dropping down to 20 for
that? Why do you pay the Citgo station $3.85 a gallon for gas?
A little while ago, we had a clear discussion. That was exactly what it was for. And we came clean, and we admitted that's what it was for.
We did not talk about a leasehold. We did not. That wasn't part of it.
Under raw, it says 30-year renewal of raw water. That's a long way from 15-year plus 15-year option
it
for
gives
renewal.
It gives you the breakdown underneath it.
It does. It says 15 years at this price, and then year 16 is at this price.
That's a 30-year agreement.
That's not an option. That's an agreement of 30 years. Just yes or no, okay. It's an agreement of 30 years.
It is.
It is. So that's different than what we agreed to.
But the option was going to be our option.
No. Not what, but. We had a bullet-pointed list that you were going to go in there and tidy up into a list. And this is not anything like what we talked about.
It is. It's very similar.
No, it's not. Very similar.
Are you wanting to put, okay, tell me how you want that to read. But it does have the breakdown underneath.
Okay, under raw, it should say, what we said it should say, a 15-year contract with an option for 15-year renewal at 20 cents a thousand.
And it's our option only.
That's what it says. Of course it is. So I'm going to change that to a 15-year renewal.
About just a 15-year contract.
And then
for
15-year contract, just like it says, and then option
at year
for the county, county option only.
Year 16.
Now, we're not dealing with a drug dealer. We're dealing with governments. We're not trying to do.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
There's no gotchas in these things.
If you need something, put it in writing.
That's what we just tried to do, but this writing is different.
I'm talking about.
But this did come back as we had talked about.
Now, there's two of the roads going at UA.
You want me to?
It needs to be an option, our option only. Because if they walk away from it, then we begin all the money at the 15, and we're stuck renegotiating the deal. I don't want to do that.
Nobody said anything any different.
Counselor, can we rewrite that so it's solid on there? And does that make sense to you? But it has to be our option only. They can't bail on us.
That's fine.
I think we should have 4% CPI cap per year.
Well, that's something
the actual economy does.
It's in the current contract.
How do we cap what the actual economy does?
It's in the current contract. How do they do it?
I don't know.
They do it the same way.
Well, you like the way they do things?
In that particular regard, yes.
I don't know how you can cap what the economy is doing. That's a factor based on.
They cap the CPI user.
And there seems so much argument for the person who's doing the contract. It's like basically people that are on our side.
There's some people that are not on our side. The whole attempt is just to fight, fight, and say.
Well, I'm not looking to do that. Stop that part of it. I relied on these couple changes, recommendations of council.
Well, you should have done that in front of the board. Because we had an agreement when you walked out. All we were doing was putting was consolidating.
I put a lot of stock in what we pay council year.
Same here.
I put a lot of stock in him, but I'm elected to represent the citizens. You're elected. Okay. Councilors is not. And I respect Ken tremendously.
All right, is there anything else? And Ken, I do wish it was a hard copy back again that looks solid. I really do. I don't want chicken scratched on there.
Would you like me to go in there and we can write this up real quick with you?
No, I can take care of it.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is that the only thing you're worried about?
It's the part up top, and then the I don't know what where the as built. I mean, they've offered to send that to us anyway.
That's fine. You want in there or not?
No.
When did they offer that?
We probably
have. I asked them if they could back up the documentation for the $1.4 million, and they said absolutely we wanted to provide that.
And the reason why they want, they just want to make sure what they're claiming they
when
have.
When did you ask them? And they actually have it.
I asked them months ago.
Nice to have.
Okay, well, what were
they
going to
ask for?
Months. Your
and we don't have a month later?
Before, he said, what
I said, is it not available to us if we need it? Because somebody's going to ask for it.
Okay.
If you want to see it, go over there.
All right.
In there or not?
What's that?
You I don't think that we...
It's only there to help protect us. Do you want to take our protection? Is my question.
We're not... I don't believe.
Not meaning to be in there to be rude. It's just there to look out for our best interest. Do you want to take our best interest down the pipe?
I don't think they're going to take all necessary action to ensure that we can do this either. I think they will support our efforts.
That's the same thing I find.
It's the same thing.
I don't think number two is accurate either. I don't think that's a...
We're trying to do based on what you asked us to do all that way.
I didn't ask you to do that. I've said all along that if we're paying a higher price than the 10 cents a gallon, that we're not responsible for anything. We have no risk. We have a known cost.
On?
Raw water. That's not our risk. If we're paying a higher than cost price, just like when we
buy... I think that's fine. I mean, really, I think it's okay. You know, I mean, that's a...
trying to be fair to them on that one, because they may get something raised, but we just want to know
that's something they, something they would have to project. That's their business, not ours. We're paying the higher.
But that shows I'm not trying to. It just seems fair. Because we've discussed an impossible road insurance.
So all I'd be looking for is under RAW, that instead of 30-year renewal, it's 15-year contract option at year 16.
For a total of?
Well, I think 15 and 15 is pretty
easy. It is. That's for a total of. Okay.
Okay.
That's,
and then under intake at the top,
mm-hmm.
I'm not sure payment is made over time during the first 15 years of existing RAW contract. Payment shall be secured irrevocable 30-year leasehold.
Because we don't want to lose our second year option. We don't want them to say it doesn't include that second 15, that's all.
So I think it should say payment shall secure optional 30-year, 15-year additional leasehold.
Why does it say that was your legal counsel
recommendation of how to wordsmith that, and you in the law school to think you know it better than the counsel does?
I absolutely do not know it better than the University of Tennessee graduate down there.
Okay.
However, this is not what we agreed to when you walked out of here to type it up.
How many times have we sat here and asked him to wordsmith something, our ideas?
We didn't ask him to wordsmith anything.
But it's always that way. It's just standard because you rely on him. That's why he's at the table. You rely on him to do that for you.
I have no problems with what Ken does for us. I've met county attorneys all over the state of Georgia, and I talked to them on it. He is the best.
I didn't give him those words. That's what I relied on counsel to do, to look out for our best interest. There's some reason why you don't like him looking out for our best interest.
That's right.
Come on. No, I don't like
him. Why don't you trust him on his words that he's put to place in there? Based on he heard the conversation at this table just like I did and you did, and this is what he felt was our best interest.
Hey. Can you help with?
I think that if you just change this right here, counselor, that's about what we agreed to when everybody walked out of here. I think you made the note there yourself. 15-year contract option at year 16.
That's the actual wording of the agreement. I don't know.
15-year
contract. Kind of wording.
I think that's all.
I think we're paying for what we received.
You want me to read that, or do you want to read that?
I think we're paying for what we received, but there's no requirement to buy any.
Why don't I go ahead and pass this out?
It just means you're irrevocably available.
We've all got a nice fresh document.
Y'all, that's it.
So we can't capitalize it. We're just paying for what we get.
We're just paying. We're paying for a right.
I mean, you know, if they can't provide it, then they're in breach of the contract.
So with respect to, I'm going to go ahead and just do this one more time and make sure we've got the language exactly. On the intake, then, basically all it would say is
are you changing that now, brother? I think you said okay.
But anything, I'm so sorry.
Well,
what you paying to do? Don't you trust your counsel?
Alan, you just twist his arm pretty good, sir.
You can't twist Ken Gerard's arm, I'm going to tell you.
Oh, I think you can. Go ahead, counsel. Please don't let it be about me, right?
All right. With respect to the intake, first of all, let me make it clear. We do not want to secure a leasehold.
Why not?
And, well, it's our choice if we secure one or not, but we don't want to. We just want no lump sum payment. I felt like we've had two agreements now come across the street, one where we were demanding 65% ownership, and one where they came back indicating we would get 65% allocation. So, with respect to the intake, I just wanted it to be clear what we're getting.
I think it's fair to say that we get 65% allocation. I think it's fair to say that we get 65% allocation. That they, however the IGA is eventually put together, then as we've talked about, we will have the ability to pull our permitted allocation through that. And they will also provide part of their permitted allocation.
The you know, we already have the language in here that basically says we have to work together to get a allocation increase over and above the existing allocations. That was in the IGA we sent over the first time. But with respect to what we're purchasing, that's what I'm a little unclear on. We're not purchasing anything with respect to the new intake or the intake, correct?
I think we're just buying all water.
Why are you paying 30 and
then that makes sense.
I don't have a problem with the leasehold for 15 years, because that's what we agreed to, and that's when this payment is paid off. It's paid off in 15 years.
Well, make that clear.
That's fine, but I don't think that you paid off in 15 years and then claim ownership of it for 30.
And I disagree with that. I mean, I understand your point. Your point is it says irrevocable 30 years when, in fact, we have the option to terminate the whole of the mess at 15.
Yes.
But make it clear that we paid for it. They can't resend us another bill saying we did.
It says that's the first sentence. There's no 15-year, there's no lump sum payment. Right, that's so the first sentence.
How much time do you need, sir?
3 minutes.
Thank you.
Motion to recess until council comes back. Second.
We have a motion and a second. There's no further discussion. Motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. We are recessed until the council comes back, which is supposed to be approximately 5 minutes.
Half an hour, 15 gallons of gas.
Oh, the other half, 31 gallons.
I get up.
Structure will secure an irrevocable 15-year leasehold for no less than 60% of the intake capacity. Finished water will be a 5-year renewal of the existing agreement with 5-year options subject to the following changes. Number one, required annual minimum purchase of $1.2 billion at 225. I guess that'd be per 1,000 gallons.
Yeah.
Up to a daily average of 6.5 million over a 30-day average. 5-year option on the same terms.
So 1.2 million is just like this.
No, 1.2 is 1.6 is what it is now.
Right.
With 1.6 to 243.
We're just capped ourselves at 6.5, 30-day average.
You know, Counselor, he's right. I think we wanted to say that's a minimum of 6.5 million on a 30-day average.
Not a minimum either.
Not a minimum.
In fact, check the second bullet, the next bullet point out.
Okay.
There's no mandatory minimum daily purchase.
We've capped ourselves at 6.5 bullet point number one.
Let's take that out.
You can't cap an average.
Air. Well, just talk to you. We're buying purchase 1.2 billion, 225 per thousand, up to a daily average of 6.5 million over a 30-day average. That is a cap of some type. We don't want a cap.
It's an average. So one day you buy less, one day you buy more. But you, in case you need more that whole month, you don't want to be capped.
Well, let's hope we don't have a 30-day average of 6.7.
No, I agree with them because you'll never use the 1.2 billion on those months we've been capped.
6.5 really comes from the concern that, you know, that we need to have the availability of
6.5. Yeah, the 6.5 is a minimum.
Minimum availability.
Minimum availability is 6.5. Right, Tim? I mean, that's what you need.
That's about all we can get now. That's what we're getting now in the summer months, July, 3 months, that we'll 6.5
minimum.
Minimum availability.
Availability for a 30-day average.
We don't have to buy it, and it's not a cap, but...
Right.
But there's a minimum of 6.5.
So that would read required annual minimum purchase
Let's stop that bullet point. Required annual minimum purchase of 1.2 billion gallons to 225 per thousand. Period. Next rule, the city shall make available no less than 6.5 NGD on a 30-day average. Period.
Right. I think that's correct. Councilor, sorry to catch that before. But,
And y'all still like there should be no mandatory minimum daily purchase?
Yes.
First 5-year term. The first 5-year term, and this will need to be reworked as well, but the idea was that the 2.25 is fixed.
Yes.
The first 5-year term is at a fixed rate.
2.25.
With the rate subject to CPIU, if we do something.
Subject to CPIU. Yeah. Rate subject to CPIU for second 5-year option. Rate subject. The last bullet point, language shall be added to reflect existing arrangement regarding the city providing water to Forsyth County for county customers that cannot be served directly by Forsyth County. That was just some loose ends where we have some unusual arrangements, like going out in some of the outlier areas where the city of Cumming does in fact provide service to our customers.
But it's not in the service area, it's just more convenient for the cheaper for the taxpayer.
Right.
It's our service area that's the only feed is from a city line, and we intend to keep buying water from the city.
We don't want to.
Day in, day out.
We don't want that to become a city service area. We're just going to have that.
We just want to let them know we're going to keep buying water at those isolated places where we don't have another supply.
Okay. Okay, with respect to raw, 15-year renewal of the raw water IGA, subject to a 15-year option, and those agreements are subject to the following changes: 30 cents per 1,000 gallons for 15 years, adjusted annually by the CPIU as calculated in the city's proposed IGA. I think there was a sentiment they had some pretty good language in there regarding how to adjust that. The county shall have the sole discretion to trigger the additional 15-year option. At year 16, assuming that is triggered, the price per 1,000 resets to 20 cents per 1,000. I'm adding that in right now. Subject to annual CPI adjustment.
Okay, and that is with the same terms as is proposed by the GA, right?
Right, same adjustment methodology.
So how does that affect, if you opt for the next 15, how does that affect the new language up top?
Well, that's what I was going to ask. We have a sentence that says, should the county exercise its option that the rate structure shall secure an additional 15-year.
It's something, because right now you're shut us down at 15, it looks like. We don't have any guarantee of that.
Just to kind of continue it through.
Yeah, that's why I had it the way we had it the first time.
But if we didn't renew, we didn't need a 30-year lease on it.
I understand. So but you understand what I was after, though.
Oh, you were after
it. Well,
I thought he was after.
I thought he did it.
Okay, he was after, but I agreed, yes.
Oh,
I said, how do you make sure we have our full 30? And he says,
those meetings behind closed doors are so sweet.
Heck, good boys.
They're not calling the kettle black.
Look out for the county's interest, so it's But now you see why, because you just said it yourself, you need to have something there.
Yeah, I understand your point. I can do that.
Will it be 5 this time or 3?
No, basically the point is under the intake, should the county exercise the additional 15-year option, then the 15-year leasehold will extend as well.
Three minutes or 5 minutes to retype it?
I'm going to retype all this. It'll take 2. Let's go through the additional terms real quick, though, and then we'll be done. Number one, city agrees to take all necessary action to ensure that EPD permission is secured for the county to treat a portion of the city's permit allocation of raw water above the city's finished water needs for customers within its service area on an as-needed basis as determined by the county. This was language we specifically discussed where I think Tim was having some concerns that we really need EPD permission for us to treat the city's allocation.
Do you need to add the language we had in the proposal we sent over subject to city's water needs or whatever that, you put in there?
Well, I think that's in there. Above the city's finished water needs for customers within its service area is in there.
Oh, I'm sorry, you're right.
Number two, when the U.S. Corps of Engineers resets its water storage contracts, the county agrees to pay a pro rata share of the adjusted storage costs based upon total water usage.
Is that retroactive, by the way?
No, it would not be. It would just be in real time when the actual reset occurs.
Well, when the Corps comes back, says we're resetting it, we're going to need another 10 for what you've been pulling for the last 7 years.
Then I'll say that this obligation shall have prospective application only.
That
going forward. Yep. City and county will cooperate to seek a county withdrawal permit application consistent with the language in the previous IGA tendered from the county to the city. We all like that. That's the whole North Metro District. Remember that? That would just be the same. And then this just firms up number four that I'm given permission when I draft this thing to take out miscellaneous, irrelevant, or previously executed terms like termination fees and basically things in these old contracts that no longer have in the application.
Okay. Should you redline that though for us? You think it would be that language just so everybody's clear?
You know, that's what I did in the first IGA. It's going to be no different than that. Okay. It's not going to be anything that would be anything substantive that should cause a concern to either side.
Now, number three says city county would cooperate, city county would draw a permit application consistent with the language. Does that really mean that the city and the county would cooperate to seek an increase?
Over, we're not asking for them to give us any of their share.
Right.
Over and above.
Do you want to add that?
Well, it's going to be, I'm going to cut and paste what was
yes.
in the old one.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Give me 3 minutes, unless y'all have anything else to add.
I think that's good. Tim, go ahead.
The numbers.
Can you run us this and send this to us so we have a...
And if this is
it. You don't have to do it right now.
Well, I think we've already...
But we need to get something.
Fixed it, I mean, just to help.
Can you get me some copies? Yeah.
We want to touch cost numbers.
We've got, I don't know if we can talk right now.
How about we give him 2 minutes so he's not back from the
just be quiet and look at something.
And the reason for that they're supposed to pay you is that
there's a company in Alpharetta.
That's what happens with the building. So she's supposed to, they want to come back tomorrow just to see what the area is really worth. And if the answer is you'll find us little Joe.
5 years.
I think we should break it.
Can I work this? Take it personal. Will you
make a motion to recess. Give me 3 minutes.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we recess until the county attorney's second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously.
So it wouldn't be, why would it be, no, he doesn't care.
Well, it's 37 max, it's 34. No, you don't, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying our the way we have our shared allocation split is between the city and the county. They predicate what we do as far as water treatment.
They're encouraging commissioners to stop and move.
Yeah, they do.
Anyhow, the current split is like the city has 22 megawatts. Right. Why wouldn't that be part of our negotiation?
We asked for
the city leaves.
Which
you guys know.
This permit's for this much. For this point, this is it.
What's their meeting? Is it on Tuesday? City Council meeting?
Okay, I'd like to call the special call work session back to order at the copies are coming from 10/24. You guys good to go?
Mr. Tam, you asking for these numbers to be in? Did you want to see them now? Just get them to you later.
I just get them to us later.
Well, I think they're here. So
okay. Okay, we are back in session. And I guess it's to you.
Yeah, there ought to be copies coming.
Chairman, I'd like to clear the air about something that was said earlier. Just so you know, when we went in the room the first time to work on the bullet points, I just want this board to know that some of the recommendations in the bullet pointed document was from staff level and not from the tenants.
You've already admitted that you were in there playing games with them.
Just a little bit.
Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Well,
for the benefit of the county, I agreed with staff when they made the recommendation.
Why don't we, if you will permit me, why don't we just focus on what we changed?
Yeah, let's just do this.
On the intake, I just added some language that says that to the extent we trigger the 15-year raw water option, that the leasehold extends for 15 years as well. That's all. Going to finished water, to Commissioner Bell's point, the second bullet point, we sort of segregated those two. So the first one required an annual minimum purchase of 1.2 billion gallons of water at 225. City, next bullet point, shall make available no less than 6.5 million gallons of water daily based on a 30-day average. So that's been made to be more clear. Golly, I mean, that was really it. I mean, we did put in the additional terms down at the bottom of subparagraph 2 that rate adjustment would only be prospective if the Corps of Engineers goes up on its storage costs.
I make a motion that we ask you to draw this up to an interim agreement and that we send this over to the city and company to buy it.
I have written.
Do you want to do your public hearing thing again?
I have a question if you may. The original one we typed up that put down the 30-year leasehold for no less than 65%. And this one we've just written up that you can go back to on twice, it had a 15-year leasehold for no less than 65% intake capacity. Then it gives additional if you do your option.
The leasehold will be the same.
Leasehold the same, so you still have a 30-year leasehold.
Right, but the difference is
15 and 15.
Right.
For a total of 30.
Correct.
Thank you.
Is there any further discussion? If not, we have a motion and a second. Please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Aye. That passes 3-1 with Commissioner Ramos being.
Okay.
So this goes up in June, after June.
You don't like this?
What do you propose to do then? What is your option? Let's send it.
Well, I wanted a cap on the CPIU.
It's in there. It's calculated by the city's proposed IGA.
No. By 4%.
Is that not in there, Councilman?
And that is a 4% cap.
Yeah.
What is in there?
Yeah, what's in the IGA for the CPIU right now?
As calculated in the city's proposed.
Is that not a 4% cap?
Jody, tell
you
it's okay.
Well, he controls me. I'm going to control him.
Oh, Lord.
The language that I was thinking of is in the city's IGA that I thought there was some discussion that we like the methodology annually after the commencement date. The fees to be paid shall be increased by the CPI with the numerator being one term, the denominator being the other term. That's what I'm talking about.
Really good. There's not a cap.
Will you agree to it if there's a cap in it?
That's what you mean. That's why we're having a discussion.
This is, you're not offering anything. Offer up something. Let's get it done. We cannot go to a June of the hearing.
The hearing versus start over again.
Or at least move to have a public hearing this May 15th.
Let's try to knock this out.
Let's get this going. But he just needs to tell us what he wants in there and make it a report.
I really like ownership.
I would too, but I'm not too much reality, unfortunately. I don't know how to get that ownership. You can't force him to do it. There's a problem. You asked what, twice?
Well, he said the reason he couldn't do it is because they have a member based system, but they don't.
I don't know.
I'd like to know who the members are, if there is such a system.
Say again?
He says he's a member-based
system. The mayor said that he has a member-based system, and the mayors did not want the intake sold. But he doesn't have a member-based system. Or if he does, I'd like to know who the members are that won't let him sell. I'm a user, and nobody ever asked me if I...
Councilor, if a motion is made to move this to the next to the public hearing for May the 15th, is that acceptable?
Okay. Yes.
And then we don't have to wait till June? Because I believe the rule says it can be moved to the next public hearing. But if we move it, if we go ahead and schedule a public hearing on...
Yeah, remember, this is what we got into. No, the next public hearing is the June public hearing. And remember, I brought out to you all in the open meeting the notion of changing your rules to make it be any public hearing calendar, and we didn't do that. So right now, your internal rules say that upon a IGA not securing a four, in this case, a unanimous vote of those that can vote, that it goes, a member can make a motion, and it goes to the next public hearing calendar, which for us is the June public hearing calendar. And that's the way we've applied it once already. I don't believe I have the discretion to change it.
Because we have to send one. So let's Wrap one up. You tell everybody what you want.
So you were never in favor of countering the offer at all? Because you haven't said anything the whole day.
I wanted ownership.
But you've not said anything. That's what you said you're doing.
I did. I asked for the 4% and everybody just blew right by it. Everybody else is so busy talking.
Oh, gosh. I thought you were running the meeting. Well, how about if we put the 4% in there?
Well, that would be better.
Will it get you to agree, or are we going to go to $1,000?
Can we go to ownership? Why don't we do ownership?
Because it's not on the table.
Who took it off?
The owner of it.
The owner says that it's a membership-based system.
He's elected to represent those members until he's not.
He's not elected by me. I don't live in the city.
Well, then you need to talk to city people.
Well, that's what I thought we were
doing.
What
in the world are you trying to
do? So you just want this contract to expire?
You obviously just want to.
We're going to let the contract expire?
Yes.
Yeah. I never had a problem with that.
And you want the citizens of Forsyth County to be subject to $1,000, $1,000 on raw water?
To be subject to anything other than a fair deal.
No, we're not talking about ifs and we're talking about reality. That's reality.
Why is that reality? It's reality that he doesn't have a member-based system.
Okay,
but which reality are you talking about?
You just
about?
Said you're comfortable with the water contract expiring, so you'd be comfortable without a source of water for the citizens of the county?
He's not going to turn it off.
No, he's going to charge us $1,000 or $1,000. You're comfortable with that.
Well, we might have to go to court then.
Are you comfortable with that?
But why don't we just try to settle it? Is
you're
that our job as elected officials to do this?
That's what you want us all along. That's what I said earlier. You really don't want to have to make this decision.
Is it, but do you want the court system to solve this for us?
What's that?
Do you want the court system to solve this for us?
If it gets us a better deal, yeah, it'd be great.
But what if it doesn't get us a better deal?
That's the chance that I'm willing to take.
So you want to sell it settle in the court system?
Or get ownership.
We're not going to get ownership, and I don't think the courts would give us ownership. Do you think the courts would give us ownership, Counselor?
Will they decree it? It depends what's on the table to the extent that we're paying a capital contribution. But I think if we just go into a courtroom and say we want ownership, I don't think we'll get ownership. But it, you know, to the
extent. What happens if the board doesn't authorize us to put a bid out?
Then we will. Well, two things could happen. I mean, depending upon what the bill is for the water, we'll either have to pay it under duress if we believe it's too high. Or escrow it. And you might have to, you know, to the extent that you believe that the board collectively decides that the bill is too high and that we don't believe the rates are justifiable, you may want me to file a declaratory judgment action or some sort of an action.
But if you don't get
the instruction from the board to commence that?
If it's at a 2-2, what happens? This is our meeting.
Who are you asking?
Well, if the board doesn't take the position that it wants to fight the rate structure, then we would simply have to pay it.
And what if you don't pay it? And what if you do it under duress? And what if you don't pay it?
Well, you're not going to do it. If you're not going to challenge it, doing it under duress makes little sense. I mean, to be candid, makes little sense. So we would simply pay it until such time as there is a
board that challenges it. Because you're not going
to
ever come up with an agreement with this board, it sounds like. How do you get an agreement?
So let me ask you a question. We have a 3-1 vote right now. Does the 3-1 vote send it across the street?
Not as a binding offer.
Okay.
That can be accepted. It's not.
Not yet, anyways.
But it can send it across the street. It's a public record. Any of us can take it across the street.
Yes. It can be sent over as a non-binding offer, as we did before. That just got a chilly
reception. Which got rejected because it wasn't binding.
Correct.
So you're willing to put all this at risk?
All this because of ownership of something?
Well, I wish you'd have told us this yesterday. We didn't need to have this meeting. What a waste
of
time.
Well, we did in order to get to this point, didn't we?
No, you could have just made the announcement.
Look at what you're talking
about. But I wouldn't have had the benefit of hearing all these arguments. Now I have.
And your point is?
I've arrived at the same place.
So you wasted staff time.
I didn't waste
anything. We've got an attorney sitting down here that's on contract. You've wasted my time You have wasted my time.
You wasted
you're
your
retired.
Time. I didn't ask you to run a business.
You're retired.
I didn't ask you to run a business. That was your choice.
Why don't you come up to a grown-up level instead of the elementary?
Well, I think this is a disservice.
It absolutely
for you to
is.
Sit here for 2 days I and think tell the board I was never going to vote on it in the first place.
I didn't say I never was going to vote on it. I said I wanted ownership.
But what did you say that yesterday?
I think he's always been on that stance.
But why did he say yes?
Something?
I don't know.
What a waste of time. I just said this morning at 8 o'clock when we started.
Okay, well, then consider it a waste of time. What do you want to do now?
I'm going to sit here until we find out what your offer is. I want you to draft an offer, tell the counselor what you want, and let's
I like the previous it. Offer. What was wrong with it?
It was not accepted, Jim.
Okay. We'll send it I back. Mean, why can't we send it back over?
What world do you live in, Jim? What world are you living in?
Ours. It's the world I live in. I was elected, and this is how I'm representing the people that elected me.
My letter to water contract expired.
Litigation.
Litigation.
Dollar a thousand, except
you're the one who don't want to go into litigation. You're the one who, if we,
it's not a, it's not
you're
a
the plan. Ones who, if we, if it comes to that, are making noises like well, we won't fund any kind of a law. We'll just pay the extra.
I think that it would be that in order to serve the citizens of the county, you should make a proposal
right now.
You should make a proposal that you
believe is fair. Let's hear it.
He just said
he wants ownership.
We all agreed yesterday that a totally reasonable proposal was the one we sent across there. In fact, you said it was superb yesterday.
Excellent. Yep. It was wonderful.
Excellent.
But it was rejected.
We'll send it again. Maybe they'll change their mind.
What world are you living in?
So that's your position, send the previous proposal back over?
Yeah, why not?
All right. I would rather.
That's a negotiation at its best.
Yeah. I think it would be more.
Actually, I've seen it done. I've seen it accepted.
Fair.
I've seen him lowered and seen him accepted.
To tell us what you want
I think it'll work,
as an offer, you want ownership. What does ownership entail? Do we get water out of it? How much do we pay for it? What are the terms of the agreement?
I like the previous agreement.
Well, Jim, that was not on the table. It's just not.
Well, then what world do you
well, maybe he can bring
you ask me to do something, world. I do it, and then you say it's not possible.
It's been rejected, Jim.
They might accept it this time.
And you're right, they might. So you're making a motion to send it back over again?
Yeah. I'll make a motion to resend the previous proposal.
Which previous proposal? Make a little clear so we know which one.
The previous binding proposal?
The April 26th proposal that was entered yesterday in the
agenda book. Is that what your proposal is?
Yes.
I'll second that. Get four votes.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
Aye. All right, we voted, though, 3-1 to send this proposal. It's
yes.
non-binding.
Yes.
Okay. All right, well, how about this? How about if we extend the existing contract?
To when? Yeah,
what's the point? I would like to make a motion that this board consider a formal censure of Commissioner Bob for shirking his responsibilities to the citizens of the county. If not, I'll follow that. Because we've heard it all along that he wants us to go to litigation so he doesn't have to make a decision. It's an election year. He doesn't want to have to listen to those people out there that he thinks are upset with the city. And it's a total disregard to the benefit of the citizens for extending and act like an elementary school child.
Well, can I ask one thing before we storm out? Just before we storm out, chill for a second. If you tell me if this here, the one that we just voted 3-1 on, if under the intake it asked for ownership instead of that, and you had a cap of 4%.
Go to June.
That you would vote for this today.
In fact, I'd June be willing to drop the 4% if it had the ownership.
So let's add it in there. We've added it in there, but that's a request and a counter.
So be it. And we get 4 votes today.
Yeah, we'll send it over.
No, yes, maybe. I mean,
I think I think Commissioner Boff has decided the direction he wants to go, and we voted 3-1. To send this proposal over here. This is a proposal that the board is behind. And, you know, it goes over June the 7th. Maybe the city would be willing to
keep things status quo for two or three weeks until we can vote on June the 7th.
Do we want to make a motion to send over non-binding?
Well, hold on a second.
Yeah.
It sounds like if you change this ownership to ownership.
You know what?
Yeah, but that's already been rejected.
I have wasted enough time with him, wasting my time and all these people's time to come in here.
This is a disservice.
It's a disservice to our staff, our citizens, and it's a total disrespect of your time, my time, and his time.
Motion to adjourn.
And his time. I'd like to ask you to withdraw that. I'd like to make a motion that we send this over as a non-binding.
Second.
I withdrew
my motion to adjourn.
Thank you.
I'd like to make a motion that we send this over as a non-binding agreement to request input from the city.
Second.
Oh, Lord.
You voted to approve it. Certainly, you voted to look at it, for which they're going to say it's not binding. Why'd you send it over here?
I know. You're right.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. That passes 4-0.
Is the board's expectation that this be distilled into an IGA we sent over, or just
I don't think we want to put any more
just the bullet point
cost into
it. I think we've wasted enough time.
Is that
wasted enough time.
Commissioner Levent, is that your?
I'm fine.
Okay, then I'll just basically take what I've got here and put a cover letter for Mr. Davis.
Can you get it over by email to him today?
I will have it to them today.
I'm going to make a motion that we request the city of Cumming leave the current raw and finished water contracts in place until June the 8th.
So we can get a legitimate answer, is that what you're asking?
So we can vote on it June the 7th.
I think that we need to allow Chairman Bob to have his way.
Let's not do that, because that's kind of... Don't let your emotions get involved in this.
It's not emotions. He's...
They might say no. They might say what you're trying to say right now. It's not a done deal. But at least we're this is looking out for the best interest of the citizens.
I have no
and
problem.
Then asking them to hold off until we can get through
the bureaucracy of that. I'll second your motion.
Well, then you have it. Sounds like it's going to fly if they accept it.
Do we need to go through June?
Let's say June 15th.
That's fair enough. Yeah. Do you second June 15th?
Okay, let me redo my motion.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm just trying to look at the calendar real quick on when their next meeting would be. They have a meeting on the 15th or the 22nd. Do you know, City? 15th?
Whatever.
Third Tuesday's
the 15th.
Will you withdraw yourself first?
Yeah, I did. I'm sorry. Okay. So then their next meeting would be the 19th of June. So, and if we vote on it on the 7th, maybe they'd call a meeting, maybe they wouldn't, who knows. So let's ask if they keep the current contract in place till June the 20th.
Second motion.
That's your motion.
Yeah.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos.
Then what I'm going to do is, when we draft the letter to Mr. Blackburn, we will simply put this in there that we're making a formal request that the existing IGAs be extended to June 20th, and then also contain these bullet points as an attachment to that letter.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Was that unanimous, Pete?
I hope I didn't push it off.
Yes.
You voted aye.
Thank you guys for all your
Appreciate your effort.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Work's a good deal. That's what we're trying to do here.
No, that did not, because the rules provide that they have to make a motion to go to a public hearing. And
because we're buying more raw,
I don't have a problem with rewarding Cumming, okay, with the fact that we get an opportunity 30 years later to get what we should have. We should have stepped up and got. Okay.
Why would we build a reservoir when there's
We look at the spots we make capital investments to those that are.
Why did you suppose? To get anything other than
If a discount to the city.
We have to get, that's
$130.
We need
to go to a conservative. You look at the facts as they are, say, you know what, we can change those facts, but why waste our energy?
Are you well today?
Yeah, good, I hope you are.
He's only going to.
Oh, yeah.
Good.
On the planning commission?
Yes. With the election coming, I didn't want to appoint somebody that didn't have any experience.